And you, it was this point, you say, that you from this study you realised the importance of time.
Absolutely, and the beginnings of a life course perspective, that really people's lives are shaped by these experiences happening through the normal developmental process of just the environments in which people grow in, but also the influence of policy on that, policy frameworks, external events, and in other words, a historical dimension to the understanding of human development, which is bringing that secular change into the picture as well. And the more I got into this, the more I realized the limitations, say, of psychology, that had no interest whatsoever in social change. It was all about, you know, a biological mechanism responding to an environment. A kind of like nature does. And that's why I became very attracted to it and saw, as I say, the limitations of psychology, and not at that point, I have to say, the limitations of quantitative methods. Mm. That came much later. But it set me on a certain path, you're right.
And you have a nice phrase that you came to realize from this study, the great power of the time dimension in social scientific inquiry. I like that phrase.
Oh, do you? Well, it's time in a variety of ways. It's historical time, developmental time. Yes, absolutely. Mm-hmm. And the time at which you do think, the time at which you collect data, the period effect. Mm-hmm. I've written a number of things about this, and it's... So time is really vital and quite complex, because it has this three effects on data at any point in time. The period, the cohort, and the development. Well, absolutely, because of course the time dimension is the other thing that structural equation modelling allows you to deal with, you see. It's made for longitudinal data, it's made for life course study. Life course study is by definition longitudinal, because one of its four components, the components of the life course, is developmental change in individuals.
Yeah.
And that's where structural equation modelling really originally paid off. And the other aspects, of course, are historical, you know, the historical shifts over time, so you mean, you know, and linked lives was the other vital thing to me about the life course.
Linked lives means the relationships with other people.
To take into account social relationships, that you're a cohort that is moving in a convoy. A cohort like the Roman army or is linked together, and at the most basic level that's a family, but it extends to the community or the people at work and all the rest of it. And that's, well, we can get onto that a bit later, the life course more generally, but all these elements, now that's the most difficult element of all to deal with in modelling, and that's where the qualitative approach comes in.